Everybody does it.
Oh.
Especially babies. And you can tell a lot about a baby's health based on the consistency, the color, the smell. Yes, I'm talking about poop. Now, I know you probably don't want to talk about it, especially since you spend so much time cleaning it up. But you also probably see a dirty diaper every once in a while that makes you wonder, is that normal?
Oh, what a fart.
So your baby's very first poop is going to look wild.
So meconium is your newborn's first poop, and it has a very sticky, thick, dark green color, almost like bile. It contains amniotic fluid, intestinal cells, bile salts, pancreatic enzymes, and so much more. And babies typically will pass this meconium in the first few hours or within a day after birth.
You're moving, you're rocking him.
Let me tell you, with our youngest, it was impressive how much meconium he pooped out at the hospital. The nurses couldn't believe how many dirty diapers he produced in that first 24 hours. Amar was born a little over 7 pounds. After getting all that meconium out, my husband said, the baby's probably only gonna weigh 5 pounds now. Okay, so after your baby clears out all that meconium, regular pooping starts. You'll notice your baby's poop becoming thinner in consistency and lighter in color.
Any earth tone is common. So parents are like, the color's orange, the color's green, the color is a different like leafy color. Totally normal for it to be any color earth tone. Eventually in breastfed babies, you may see more yellow seedy stool. Formula fed babies may just have more of that greenish stool.
And you'll be able to see that there is a liner in here that's clipped in. It's clipped in the back as well as in the front.
Now he's not gonna appreciate me sharing this when he's older, but this is my eldest unloading in the middle of his first bath. This was pretty traumatizing for me and my husband. But that color you're seeing, apparently that's normal. Now Dr. Mona says there's two colors to look out for, black and white poops.
This could be a sign of old blood, meaning not fresh blood, but blood that's somewhere in the digestive tract that we don't know about or that was kind of digesting, and now they're pooping it out. Now, if your child has white poop and looks yellow in the skin, this is a red flag because this can be a sign of jaundice and an obstruction in the biliary tract. The biliary tract is what gives us our colors of poop.
And of course, red bloody poops are red flags.
There's a difference between if it looks bloody or if it's just red, right? So bloody may have a little bit of mucus in it. You may see streaks.
Okay, so now that we've covered all the colors of the rainbow, let's move on to frequency. How often should your baby poop?
Some babies will go every day, multiple times a day, but many breastfed babies will sometimes go 7 to 10 days without pooping once breastfeeding is established.
So it's normal to go more than a week without pooping, and it's normal for your baby to poop multiple times a day.
It's really important to remember that. Every baby is so unique. Babies tend to poop around feeding times. They have something called a gastrocolic reflex, which is basically when you eat something, it can stimulate you to poop. So you may be finding that you're doing a lot of diaper changes right after you feed them in that newborn period.
Now, as a mom of 4 kids, I can tell you, it gets real once you start solid foods. Whew.
So you are gonna see a wild ride when poop happens around that time of starting solids. So they can sometimes get constipated as liquid intake reduces, right? Now they're eating more food.
It's not just the frequency and the consistency that change.
As they get introduced to more food, you're gonna see the color change a lot too.
And let me tell you, the smell will be the biggest change. My youngest, now that he eats solids, his poop stank like they came out of an old man that works on ships. Like, how long have you been at sea, Amar? Do you have scurvy?
They're gonna get vegetables, fruits, different cereals, different meats, whatever you're giving your child, and that is gonna come into their poop, right? So it's gonna smell. It's not gonna be that normal newborn poop that was just yellow and seedy and pretty basic of a scent. Now you're gonna have the scent of almost adult-style poop.
He doesn't like to get his diaper changed.
Now, if you start seeing your baby making a face with their bowel movements, don't worry. They're probably not constipated.
So parents will often see that their baby's pushing hard and they think that that's constipation. It may be something called infant dyskeusia. Infant dyskeusia is basically a discoordination of the muscles. So it's not that they're constipated, it's just that they're learning, well, whoa, I have to poop now? This is different. So they bear down, they make a grimace, they may turn red in the face.
Not gonna lie, seeing my baby scrunching up his little determined face and clenching his little fist, it was pretty cute. So basically, anything outside of what we just talked about being normal, like diarrhea, you should talk to your pediatrician. I mean, if you had diarrhea, you'd probably get medical help too. And I don't mean your mom.
The most important thing is to look at the big picture. If the child has looser poop but is gaining weight on their growth curve, is otherwise thriving, is not bothered by it, this is awesome. If they're losing weight, if they're very bothered by it, if they have a fever, and most importantly, if there's blood in the poop, it's really important to bring this up with your child's clinician.
Well, I don't know about you, but after all that potty talk, I am pooped. Thank you for watching Seeker Baby. I'm Angel Laketa Moore, and I hope you're learning as much about babies as I am. If there's a baby topic you want us to cover, leave us a comment and keep coming back to Seeker for more on babies. See you next time.